This presentation covers management considerations for Plum Curculio, which we'll look at first, followed by the key internal feeding moth pests. Plum Curculio management strategies have traditionally been based on a number of assumptions. First, that commercial apple orchards in New York do not harbor indigenous infestations of Plum Curculio adults, and that the adults overwinter in ground debris outside of the orchard. Plum Curculio adults begin to immigrate into the edges of orchards from outside sources in the spring before petal fall, when temperatures reach about 55 or 60 degrees. And they're usually in the trees during bloom. The length of the oviposition period depends on seasonal temperatures after petal fall. And finally, the assumption that effective control requires preventive insecticide sprays from petal fall until the end of the oviposition period. However, in order to simplify the management process, a Plum Curculio oviposition model was developed. And it starts with the current understanding that egg laying generally starts after 1 to 2 warm evenings, about 60 degrees Fahrenheit, following petal fall. But this model, which was empirically derived by comparing cumulative Plum Curculio oviposition and degree day accumulations after petal fall of max, predicts that fruit requires protection from petal fall only until the end of the adult's migration period into the orchard, which occurs at about 308 degree days. This corresponds with about 40% of the cumulative oviposition the beetles are capable of. Now, the reason that this works is that if protective insecticide sprays have controlled all the Plum Curculios that were in the orchard from the start of the egg-laying period up to this point, and no more adults are likely to immigrate into the orchard, then the rest of the beetles' activity of laying eggs outside of the orchard is really of no concern since it won't impact the crop. Let's look at how this might play out during the season. For instance, in 2005, petal fall was on May 23rd, at which time a petal fall spray would have been applied. If that spray provided 2 weeks of protection, that would take us to June 6th, by which time we had 165 degree days accumulated. From a first cover spray applied at that time, 2 weeks more of additional protection would bring us to June 20th, corresponding to 463 degree days. And since the end of the migration period would have occurred on June 11th, only 2 total sprays were needed that year for adequate protection against Plum Curculio. However, the next year, 2006, petal fall was on May 15th, and the petal fall spray only carried us to 120 degree days by May 30th. And the first cover spray extended the protection period to June the 12th, when we had 291 degree days, which wasn't quite enough. So a second cover spray was needed to get past that 308 degree day point, making a total of 3 sprays necessary to adequately protect against Plum Curculio oviposition damage that year.